I would first like to congratulate the organization of this seminar for allowing us to participate and share different perspectives from different languages far away from our own countries. On behalf of the Galician Academy of the Portuguese Language, I would like to send a special thanks to Gilvan Oliveira for his dedication to the UNESCO chair. We hope to see you in Santiago de Compostela, perhaps in a future meeting or seminar of this UNESCO network. The sentence, "my lost and found language," could serve as a synthesis of the process that approximately started in 1970s has developed in Galicia in relation to the question of the model of start and language. This is what, through the centuries, had been referred to in Italy as the questione della lingua. I purposefully use the phrase "my lost and found language" as title, taking it from late Professor Ernesto Guerra da Cal, a Galician exile that became Professor Emeritus of the University of New York. Guerra da Cal was one of the main 20th century defenders of the idea that spoken Galicians would be represented by the same writing system used in Portugal and other Portugal-speaking countries. This basically is the same idea that Professor Ricardo Carvalho Calero put forward from 1980. The same criteria was adopted by Professor Celso Cunha and Lilley Sintra in their New Grammar of Contemporary Portuguese published in 1984, including Galician dialects among those of European Portuguese, giving continuity to the pre-existing linguistic tradition. In the process of political change or political evolution from the Francoist dictatorship to the current regime, substantiated in the Constitution of 1978, there were expectations about the creation of a legal and political system that could bring equality, freedom, and recognition to all the linguistic communities that previously had been forgotten and repressed in the territory of the Spanish state. Unfortunately, the previous hierarchy between the Spanish and the other languages continues to be absolutely in force. In this context, the creation of a standard for a Galician language should have been developed on the basis of the European national languages models. These are based in several formulas for the coexistence and balance between the different popular dialects and the literary standard. Such a standard should be used to promote the elevation from orality to national language and, in this process, the recognition of the Portuguese as a legitimated variety of a wider communication would have been key. This would have allowed to overcome the obstacle that the Valencian sociologist Luis Aracil called interposition, the inevitability of Spanish in all spheres of life, particularly in the public sphere. The reconnection with Portuguese would have endowed Galician speakers with a useful communication instrument, achieving the needed prestige and developing further skills. This would have also been relevant to improvising the standard of living and the strategic value of Galicia as the key for the Portuguese-speaking world. Against expected and logical reasoning, and turning away from tradition and the consolidated common sense in the pre-Civil War about Galician cultural arena, in the context created with the coup d'etat of 1981, the autonomous government approved in 1983 a regional language model without any consultation of the newly created parliament. This model was subsidiary and dependent on the Spanish language in terms of orthography, of morphology and lexicon, constraining communication skills and severing the linguistic capacities to re-engage with Portuguese-speaking world. The governmental decree presented as a real solution that allegedly facilitated the identification of people with their own language, the fala popular, people's speech, in fact, increased its subordinate role. The isolationist or isonationist model mainly sponsored by the Royal Galician Academy, not only failed to compensate the previous and ongoing Spanish cultural domination, but actually reinforced it. This was demonstrated in practical terms in the following decades, with a sustained loss of language users, unfortunately. In spite of all the political intervention in linguistic affairs during the last four decades, and all the efforts to create and consolidate a new language in the international language classification, reality continues to be obstinate. Students are taking Portuguese language courses beginning at the intermediate level because, in spite of its legal consideration as a foreign language in Galicia, all students are able to understand it from the first minute. Focus is not about learning a new and different language, but an alternative system of spelling, different oral forms and lexicon which, while different Spanish forms have introduced in Galician standard, often reconnect with traditional forms. Reports from the Galician Association of Portuguese Language Teachers indicate that 90% of students claim that they are learning another standard of the same language. In the present moment, the public discussion about the standard language continues, fortunately, in other terms, achieving an institutional expression, reaching a small but significant understanding between different divergent parties, and which Act 1, 2014 of the Galician Parliament, for the use of the Portuguese language and links with the Portuguese-speaking world, that passed unanimously by the members of Parliament, we are now in a different moment. The bill, also known as Pas Andrade Act, was taken to Parliament through a people's legislative initiative supported by the signatures of over 17,000 citizens. While the Act does not represent a full solution to the problem, evidently, it represented the beginning of a new stage. The law includes, briefly, four main mandates. First, insertion of the Portuguese language in school system. Second, capacitation of public servants in Portuguese language. Third, development of the exchange of audiovisual materials with producers from Portuguese-speaking countries and open broadcasts of TV and radio signals from Portugal. Fourth, integration of Galicia in the international Portuguese-speaking organizations and promotion of bilateral relationships with Portuguese-speaking countries. Last year, the Galician Parliament discussed and unanimously passed a motion for the adherence of Galicia into the community of Portuguese-speaking countries, considering that linguistic reasons are the main basis for such a political move. This development could reinforce the value of Galician Portuguese as a language standard in construction alongside another national variants in Portuguese-speaking world. In fact, the Galician Academy of Portuguese Language, in which I am honored to serve as a vice-president, introduced a Galician lexicon in several orthographic vocabularies published in Portugal and the spell checker program named FLIP. The annual Galician Literature Day is dedicated this year, 2020, to one of the most important authors of contemporary Galician literature and literary scholarship, Ricardo Carvalho Calero. Carvalho has been ostracized and systematically excluded because of his defense of language unity of Galician and Portuguese, considering like a foreign novelist. This positive decision, a new decision, seems to indicate the desire of political institutions to open a new era, heated by a new tone and understanding of the problem, far from rigid placement from the past. Thus, Carvalho Calero's ephemeris can become a new opportunity, a new beginning, a new context for mutual understanding, contributing to the acknowledgement of Galician as a variety of or a standard of a global language. This development can, in the near future, lead up to virtuous outcomes, complicity networks, and public political articulations without exclusions. Not so long ago, in 1891, in Tui, a small Galician village, The first president of the Royal Galician Academy, Manuel Murguia, stated that we can never grateful enough to the Portuguese people for transforming our language in a national language. And that's why there should be no obstacles to acknowledge in 2020 that our language is internationally called Portuguese. Portuguese language, and also, naturally, Galician. Thank you very much.